Okay, I believe that's all in here.
This is Houston. Say again, please.
Oh, Houston, we have smoke.
Imagine flying 240,000 miles away from Earth, landing on a dead silent rock, only to realize one wrong calculation and you'll never come back. NASA loves to celebrate the one small step for man, but what they don't usually talk about is how close those astronauts came to death. And here's the kicker. Some people still believe NASA hid recordings of creepy space sounds and even alien signals. But which part is real science and which is myth? Stick with me until the end, because the answer will change how you see the Apollo missions forever.
July 16, 1969, Apollo 11 launches. Millions watch live. Armstrong and Aldrin prepare to land. Suddenly, computer alarm 1202. The guidance computer is overloaded. The module veers toward a deadly rocky crater. With seconds of fuel left, Armstrong takes manual control. He lands with only 20 seconds of fuel remaining. But that wasn't even the deadliest risk, because what came next, the return to Earth, nearly killed them. After splashdown, water starts leaking inside the capsule. Aldrin jokes later, imagine drowning after walking on the moon. Rescue teams save them in time. But Apollo 12 wouldn't be so lucky. They faced something no astronaut had trained for, lightning striking a rocket mid-launch. November 1969, the Saturn V rocket is hit by lightning twice, 36 and 52 seconds after launch. Cockpit fills with alarms, dozens of red warning lights. Conrad considers aborting, but Alan Bean remembers a single engineer's obscure training note. Switch SCE to AUX. He flips it. Miraculously, the power comes back. Sounds like a Hollywood movie, right? But wait until you hear what happened on Apollo 13, where NASA didn't know if the crew would live long enough to even see Earth again. April 1970. An oxygen tank explodes in space. The command module loses power, oxygen, and heat. Astronauts huddle in the lunar module, meant for two men, now carrying three. Freezing cold, starving, one develops a bladder infection. Flight director Gene Kranz, John Aaron, and NASA engineers improvise fixes with duct tape, plastic bags, and manuals. Against all odds, Apollo 13 slingshots around the moon and returns safely. But here's the disturbing truth. The Apollo missions didn't just flirt with disaster. They started with death before ever reaching space. January 1967. Gus Grissom, Ed White, Roger Chaffee prepare for a test on Apollo 1. The cabin filled with pure oxygen. Any spark is lethal. A wire shorts. Fire spreads instantly. The hatch can't be opened from inside. All three die within minutes. After that, NASA redesigns the spacecraft. New hatch, safer atmosphere, stricter testing. That tragedy, though often forgotten, saved every Apollo mission after. But what about the so-called creepy sounds astronauts heard on the far side of the moon? Let's dive into that and separate myth from science. Some Apollo astronauts reported hearing strange whistling or music when orbiting the far side of the moon. Conspiracy theories exploded. Alien transmissions, secret recordings NASA hid. Pop culture grabbed it. TV shows, clickbait videos, UFO forums. In reality, the sounds were radio interference between the lunar module and command module. Engineers confirmed it. Overlapping VHF signals created eerie feedback. Astronauts knew it wasn't aliens, but the mystery was too good for tabloids to ignore. So, why do these myths spread?
Simple. Humans love mystery more than math. Alien whispers are more exciting than signal interference. Apollo wasn't just about planting flags. It gave us innovations still in use today. Miniaturized computer chips, modern laptops, satellite navigation, GPS origins, fire-resistant materials, firefighter suits, medical tech, portable heart monitors, and perhaps the biggest gift, the Earthrise photo, the first time humanity saw our fragile blue planet floating in darkness. But here's the real question. After all that risk, after all that progress, why haven't we been back to the moon since 1972? Apollo cost over $25 billion, about $150 billion today. The Vietnam War drained budgets. Public lost interest. After Apollo 11, ratings plummeted. In the end, Apollo 17 was the last mission in 1972. But now, more than 50 years later, NASA plans to return under the Artemis program. And the dangers? Just as real as they were in 1969. The Apollo missions were a dance with death that changed human history. From fires and explosions, to lightning and computer failures, to myths of alien, they showed us what humans can do when courage and science collide. Now, I want to hear from you. 1. If you had the chance to go to the moon, knowing the risks, would you go? 2. Do you think the myths, like alien signals, help keep space exploration exciting, or just distract from the real science? 3. And here's the big one. Do you believe humanity will actually land on the moon again by 2026?